And the things of the world, the lust of the eyes, the lust of the, in the pride of life. That's the things that you're a slave to. A slave to him is an obedient heart unto God. That power comes from God. It's given to you from God. And it's the only way you're going to be redeemed from the corrupting influence of sin, is to be a partaker of that divine nature. And perhaps you know somebody that's a partaker of that divine nature. They're different, aren't they? They're different. They're not like the rest of the world. They don't go out running around drinking and cussing and taking risks, seeing how close to the edge of the pit they can stand and still say they believe in Jesus. See, they take it seriously. They have a sense of urgency in their heart to raise their kids in the right way, to get them into that kingdom. Because that's the most important thing. It doesn't matter if you earn all the money in the world. It doesn't matter if you become the richest person and the most famous. It ain't going to matter, because when you die, you're going to stand before God with nothing. You're going to stand there and you're going to answer to God himself at the judgment seat. And all is going to matter is, what did you do with Jesus and his truth? He came, he told us his truth. He gave it to us crystal clear in words that anybody, that a child could understand. But you rejected it. You rejected it for a million different reasons, thinking you had it made. You had a good life, and you had your little slice of heaven here on earth. A lot of people do in this country anyway. But see, it's not going to work that way. It's not going to work that way, and you're going to find out one day when more generations are swallowed up by death. See, every generation is going to be consumed by death. Every generation. Our littlest kids, our newest born baby, one day will be swallowed up by death. Everyone in every generation has answers to God. You will return to him. So where does this faith come from? Basically, it comes from a godly sorrow, a conviction in our heart, not merely to admit that you're a sinner, but a pleading with God, a broken-hearted repentance that makes your heart soft, that it will obey God and not rebel against him anymore for a million reasons. Because you just don't want to do what he wants you to do. That's what will happen. So redemption takes place through the power of his grace, working through faith and purifying the heart of sin. That's what it teaches in the Bible. That's what it teaches about salvation. It's very simple. It doesn't take a genius to understand it. It's very, very simple. It works through the power of his grace, working through faith, that purifies the heart of sin. Heart purity is the purpose of the commandment. The purpose of the commandment. They'll tell you that heart purity is impossible. Nobody's pure. Everybody's defiled. That's just not true. It's not true. That's the purpose. The Bible calls it the purpose of the commandment. Just like they say it's not of works, but the Bible says it's of a working faith. Faith works by love. It has to work by some principle. So then you can follow and obey Christ, apart from all the notions and traditions and the wickedness that was within, because you're putting it off. You're crucifying the deeds of the body. See, the reason that most professed Christians are not crucifying the old man with his passions and desires is because they think they can get into heaven with a double mind, serving two masters, and doing whatever they want. That's the impression that they're getting from the preachers. Well, it's not the impression that you get when you read the Bible, if you want to read the Bible. But you certainly can do that. It doesn't take a genius to understand what Christ said about entering the kingdom. So faith can become substance and evidence in your heart and in your life and be committed to God just as you would to a marriage that you're dedicated to. That's the saving faith. That's the difference between evidence of the unseen, seeking God, and the substance of faith that saves your soul. There's a big difference between knowing and doing. You all want the best for your families. You work hard and you sacrifice and you hope and you pray and you're nice to others most of the time. You know, you pray at your meals, and some of you attend church. You've attended church in the past, and you talk about God, you know, and you get warm and fuzzy when somebody prays at their meals, and you believe in something, and you hope that that's going to be enough to get everybody into heaven when you die, and it's pie in the sky, and by when you die. But you won't seek out what it really means to follow God. See, what are those things based on? Are they based on truth? A solid truth that you can sink your teeth into? Are notions, what men are saying, what people are saying, what professed Christians are saying. I grant you that most of it's based on notions, not on the solid truth. So the only way you can answer these questions and consider these things is to look into the Scriptures yourself. Go over this again. Consider in your heart what it means to follow God. How simple this is. How simplistic God has made it. Don't remain complacent and hope that you're doing the right thing and God's going to take you into the kingdom anyway because you're nice and you just don't want to talk about it because it's too controversial. It's not too controversial. Search it out and follow and obey Christ until you know you're following and obeying Him. That's all we ask. That's all we ask. We just want to see you in the kingdom. We don't want to see you lost for eternity because you missed your chance to follow Christ because of all this delusion today. And it's massive. The delusion is massive. You're being told a million different things. I tried to give you in this short presentation the simple way to follow Christ, to follow and obey Him. Doesn't it make sense that that's the way into the kingdom? So take that way, and we can help you along in any way possible that we can. Through the Scriptures, through studies and prayer. You don't have to go to our church. You don't have to go to any church. But you have to follow Him and seek Him. And that's going to make a difference in your life. A big difference. I guarantee it.
I don't know how to make it any more plain. I'm just crying out from my heart to you. The Lord's showing me these things. And He'll show you. I'm nothing special. I'm nobody. I am nobody. I'm unknown but well known, like Paul says. I'm nobody in this world. The dung of the